Hello students, and welcome back to Microbial Concepts. So this is a video where I have combined all the Viva questions just related to the staining techniques. Okay, staining techniques for bacteria, okay, not for fungi. So for fungi, already a separate video is uploaded where I have discussed everything in detail about lactophenol cotton blue staining for fungi. Okay, even Viva questions are also discussed. In this video, I have just focused on the staining techniques which we use for bacteria, say for endospore, for cell wall differentiation or flagella, capsule, everything. Okay, even the basics like what is modern, what is fixative, etc., etc. Okay, so this will be a revision video for you, and if you have staining techniques for your practicals, practical exams, then do watch this video before going to your exams. Okay, so let's start. So first question is, what is the objective of staining? Why we perform staining? So it improves the visibility by greater contrast between the organism and background, and it helps to differentiate various morphological types. Like we can differentiate depending on the shape, depending on the size, depending on the arrangement, okay, and depending on the cell component, like cell organelle, like flagella is present or not, does the bacteria has capsule or not, etc., etc. Okay, so that's the reason why we stain our microorganisms, or not just in case of microorganisms, any biological sample, if you stain, it improves the visibility and it helps you to differentiate depending on the background, various aspects. Okay, so that's the reason we stain our samples, microbial or any biological specimens. Next is, what are the functions or role of a fixative? Now in microbiology we use heat as a fixative. Okay, so the functions or roles are like, first is it kills the organism. Second, it causes the organism to adhere to the slide. Okay, so that when you wash by water, when you wash your slide by water, the sample will not get washed off. Okay, it will stick to your slide. And third is, it alters the organism so that they are more readily accept the stain or dye. Okay, that's the rule. Then what is mordant? Now mordant is a chemical that we use while staining, and it forms an insoluble complex, okay, with the stain. Okay, so for example, in Gram staining we use Gram's iodine, which forms an insoluble complex with crystal violet, and it fix the stain. Okay, so when you wash your slide, if the sample or if your microorganism is Gram positive, then the crystal violet will not get washed off. Okay, and it fixes, your stain gets fixed, and it causes the stain to penetrate more deeply into the cell. That's the role of mordant. Then what is decolorizer? Then decolorizer, it is a chemical used to remove the excess stain in indirect regressive staining. Okay, for example, in case of Gram staining we use ethanol. Okay, we don't want excess of the stain on our slide. Okay, because we want a clear image, we want to study our sample or specimen, so we don't want the excess stain to interfere, so we wash it off. So that is where we use decolorizer. Okay, so next question is, define stain. So in a simple sentence, you can define it as a coloring agent which is used for coloring the biological material or specimen. Or you can also define it as, a stain is an organic compound containing a benzene ring plus a chromophore and an oxochrome group, okay, which stains the biological material. Now till here it was about basics of staining techniques. Now we are starting with the staining methods for, say, capsule, okay, or flagella, or depending on the cell wall, flagella, capsule, endospore, everything. So first is about capsule staining. So in capsule staining we use Congo Red, right? So in capsule staining, Congo Red stains what? So it stains the background. So if you remember, in the manual staining method of the capsule staining, we use Congo Red and the manual stain. Okay, so we have another question here which says, why color change is seen in case of Congo Red? So in manual stain, there is acetic acid present. So due to the presence of acetic acid, the pH is shifted to acidic side, and due to which the conqueror stain it turns red to blue, okay, and red to blue in color, and that's why we see the background is in blue color. Okay, now next is which dye stains endospore in Schaeffer-Fulton's method. So here are the questions from endospore staining. So malachite green is the dye which stains the endospore. Then why heating is required in endospore staining? So heating is a fixative, we know that, and the role is heating will make we heat more than say 5 minutes, right? So heating will make the spore wall more permeable to the malachite green, which will help the malachite green to penetrate, and as it was previously resistant to the stain. Okay, so that's the reason we heat more in the endospore staining. Now in the Dorner's method of endospore staining, so there are two methods. The second one is the Dorner's method of endospore staining, which dye solution stains the background. So there is nigrosin solution. Okay, now about ZN staining, or we call it as acid fast staining. So the question is, what is acid fastness? So acid fastness is a physical property of certain bacteria which has resistance to the decolorization by acid. Okay, so they are resistant to the decolorization by acids, okay, during the procedure, staining procedure. Why? Because they have a unique cell wall structure, and we can identify these bacteria using a stain that is acid fast stain. Okay, so this is the reason we call, or we know these bacteria by having the property of acid fastness. Now next is, what is use of mordant in the ZN staining, that means acid fast staining? So mordant is used as heat. Okay, then what is used as decolorizer in the ZN staining? So as it is resistant to the acids, decolorization by acids, depending on the sample, it can be 1%, 5% or 20% of H2SO4 and 95% of the alcohol. Okay, and what is the use of counter stain used in the ZN staining? So malachite green is used, or methylene blue is used as a counter stain in ZN staining. Now next is about Gram staining. So in Gram staining, what is used as mordant? So Gram's iodine is used as mordant. Then primary stain is crystal violet. Safranin is the counter stain, right? And in case of Gram staining, we differentiate the bacteria depending on what? So we differentiate bacteria depending on the cell wall composition, right? So now what is the difference between? So this can be your first question, and depending on your answer, the examiner can ask this particular question. That is, what is the difference between cell wall composition of Gram positive bacteria and Gram negative bacteria? So Gram negative bacteria has a thin peptidoglycan layer in the cell wall, and it is surrounded by an outer membrane containing lipopolysaccharides. Okay, this is about the Gram negative. And in case of Gram positive, they lack the outer membrane but are surrounded by the layers of peptidoglycan. So you can say that Gram negative bacteria have thin peptidoglycan layer, whereas Gram positive have a thicker peptidoglycan layer, okay, many times thicker than is found in the Gram negative. Okay, so that's the difference between cell wall composition of Gram positive and Gram negative bacteria. Now what is monochrome staining? So this is also a kind of staining technique we use in bacteria. So just for quickly studying the shape or the morphology, we use monochrome staining. So here we use only one dye for staining purpose. We let the dye react and we wash our slide, and directly we use it for visualization under microscope. Okay, so we don't use any counter stain here. We use only single dye, that can be a crystal violet or safranin, any kind of dye you can use for staining purpose, just to see what is the shape of your bacteria or what is the morph. So next question is, what is the alternative primary stain in Gram staining? So that is gentian violet or methyl violet. Alternative counter stain in Gram staining, you can use diluted carboxyfoxin or neutral red. Okay, now last question is related to flagella staining, that is, what is the principle of Lifson method of flagella staining? There is another method, that is RYU, but that is not commonly used in colleges, so I have just listed about the Lifson method. So Lifson's flagella stain method uses tannic acid and a dye. So when bacterial flagella, it absorbs this tannic acid and a dye, it forms a colloidal precipitate, due to which the flagella gets colored and it also gets increased in the diameter. Thus, it helps us studying the flagella under light microscope. Okay, so that's how the flagella stains. Okay, so I hope all these questions and this video is helpful to you. Do give a thumbs up, do like my video, do share my videos with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified on each new video that I upload. Okay, so this was about this brief video on all the viva questions of these staining techniques. If you want another video on any topic just for viva questions, then do mention that topic under comment box, or you can reach me out on Instagram or by Gmail. Okay, so I will try to upload a video separately for viva questions or interview questions. Okay, let me know the topic, I will try to help you out. Okay, thank you.